Hey guys, how you doing today? This video is being made from a request. Kid Aaron has asked to hear my Pete Rose story. Now, if you guys watched the recent video where I called in to the WLW radio show in Cincinnati, I've been following Lance McAllister on Twitter, and it was like yesterday or the day before, maybe the day before that, sometime in the past couple days, Pete Rose was a guest on his show. And Lance was tweeting about Pete Rose being there, and I tweeted back that, Pete Rose chewed me out when I was 9 years old. And Kid Aaron tweeted today, he says, "Dude, I've got to hear your story." Well, here it is. Back when I was a kid, back in the 70s, I was a huge baseball fan. I loved the Reds, and that was during, the Big Red Machine of the 70s. You know, Johnny Bench and Pete Rose and Dave Concepcion and Joe Morgan, George Foster. Who else was on that team? I don't remember. I'm not recalling the names at the moment. But I was a huge fan of that team. And probably Pete Rose was probably my favorite player on the team, him and Johnny Bench. Well, at that time, there's a local supermarket chain called Kroger's. Now, I don't know if they extend outside of the Cincinnati area or not. But they had these specials, like during the baseball season. Like if you bought, like, remember you could buy Coke or Pepsi in the big bottles, the 16-ounce bottles. Well, they had some kind of special going all the time that, you buy like a 6-pack of the bottles and you'd get like a Coca-Cola, a Reds glass or something like that. I remember at one time they had these 8x10 black and white photos of each Reds player. And my grandma, every time she would go to the supermarket, she would buy whatever it took to get this picture. And I got all of them. I collected the entire team. And my grandpa took me to a game down at Riverfront Stadium. And we weren't too far from the dugout, so I was able to go down to the dugout and, hang over. And whenever, a player would come out from the dugout, I could scream. And, it wasn't just me. There were a lot of people there. And, they would sign autographs and stuff like that. And this was back when you could actually do that. I mean, you could sit at the dugout and, if a player came out, you could ask for an autograph. And they'd actually stand there and autograph for you. And, they wouldn't charge you for it. God love the good old days. But anyway, my grandfather took me to the game, and I remember getting every autograph except Pete Rose. And I don't remember why I didn't get Pete Rose. I'm assuming that I just didn't see him, because, I don't have any Pete Rose stories as far as being at the game goes. And I went to a lot of games. I went to a lot of games when I was a kid. I really, really loved baseball. And again, Pete Rose was probably one of my favorite players at the time, him and Johnny Bench. anyway, sometime between 76 to 78 or 9, I was like 8 to 10 or 11 years old. My sister and her friend and me and my friend, we went to Arby's in Western Hills in Cincinnati. And there was a commotion outside, and we went outside to see what was going on, and there was Pete Rose driving a silver Porsche. And I'm pretty sure it was a silver Porsche. And, Pete, if you see this, you can let me know if you drove a silver Porsche in the late 70s. I'm pretty sure it was a silver Porsche. But, as I said, I was a kid. I could be, totally wrong on that. But anyway, Pete Rose was out there, and of course, there were, quite a few people standing around, and they're getting autographs and stuff like this. And I guess, just as a kid, I assumed, that he would, just sign an autograph for me. And so when it got to my turn to, speak to him, I was like, I asked him, could I have your autograph? And he says, "Well, do you have anything to sign?" I was like, "Oh, no, I don't." So I just wait here, and I ran into Arby's, and I grabbed a napkin. And I came back outside, and I handed it to him, and he said, "Do you have a pen?" And I was like, "No, I don't have a pen." And his exact words were, "Damn it, don't you come prepared for anything?" I mean, you say that to a little kid, you know, one of your fans. That destroyed my image of baseball. I haven't been a fan of baseball since then, and I haven't been a fan of him since then. He totally ruined that sport for me, and I haven't been a fan of his since. Now, do I think that he deserves his spot in the Hall of Fame? Yes, I do. I'm not that type of person. I don't, you know, take, you know, personal things and hold grudges as far as, you know, like their personal achievements go. Pete Rose was a hell of a baseball player, probably the greatest baseball player that's ever lived, and he deserves his spot in the Hall of Fame. And it turns my stomach that he still hasn't gotten in, you know, regardless of the gambling. Now, I don't know much about what happened because, you know, by the time all that happened, I was, you know, totally off with baseball and I didn't keep up with it. But it was my understanding that he was betting on the Reds, but he was betting on... Sorry, guys, Mrs. Mully just called and it cut the video off. Anyway, what I was saying was, it was my understanding that with the gambling, that he was gambling on the Reds, but he was gambling on them to win. And and anybody that knows about this, you can correct me if I'm wrong. Because I honestly, this is my rough understanding of it. So, if he was betting against the Reds and he was throwing games and stuff like that, yeah, I can understand that. But like I said, it was my understanding he was betting on the Reds to win, and I don't see the problem with that. You compare, you know, gambling on a baseball game to stuff that happens today, and you know it's mild. But anyway, that's my Pete Rose story, and I dislike the man, but I'm rooting for him to get into the Hall of Fame, and good luck with that, Pete. But sorry, bro. Not a big fan anymore. Alright, guys. I'll leave you guys at that. Everybody have a good day, and don't let your meat loaf.